Okay, now I'm going to give you just a few hints on setting up and shipping the printer. But to ship the printer, you need to put it into shipping mode. Okay. I'm going to go into the SwiftColor folder, and I'm going to select the 140109 Service Utility. Click on that. I'm clicking in so you get the Service Utility. It goes into Administrator mode. Okay, it does require a password to type it incorrect. And then it'll come up with select the connecting port, a USB, network or offline, we're using USB. You're going to hit OK. And here you can get the printer information as well, so it gives you the serial number, it gives, which is the model, the serial number, a total print count. So I've already printed over 46,000 labels from this printer. The humidity and device temperature, parts counter, so it tells you what those are. And, you know, it's a concurrent standard time, it's correct, so. You can also read this information from the printer if I hit the read from printer button, but I don't need that. You know, there's head information. So they have a lifetime on your printheads in this utility. So you can see I've got about 25% use on my printheads, except for the blue, the cyan. It's down to 15%. Gives you the head temperatures, the date the printheads were installed. There's also a cleaning utility on this, and this is where we are going to find our shipping the printer preparation for transportation. You need to do this to get the excess ink out of the printhead area. I'm just going to briefly go through the other tabs on the service utility. Test print adjustment. Here you can look at the different margins and labels and stuff. This is where you can do some test prints, adjust your head position, a few other adjustments here. You can get firmware updates, parts replacement if you need to replace the printhead, the purge unit, or the lay cleaner. That's all in this service utility, or the PCB, print module replacement. There's a lot of different replacements here. There's a troubleshooting tab, so you can see the different things here. Head cleaning position, head install position, purge unit install position, etc. Right now we're going to go back into cleaning, and I'm going to click on the shipping the printer tab. Cleaning, make sure the printer is not operating. Do not start any other operation during the cleaning. Do you want to proceed? Yes, I do want to proceed. So now it's doing a cleaning. You can see here it's cleaning out the nozzles. And we just wait until that's done. Cleaning on 26 or 27. It says remove the ink tanks, close the ink tank door, confirm the maintenance pressure door is closed. You want to cancel the preparation before shipping, hit the cancel button. Ink loading will be done when you turn on the power next time. So now we're going to remove the ink cartridges. I'm going to put them in some boxes and get it ready for shipping. And when you turn the power on next time, make sure you put the ink cartridges back in and it will reload the ink into the printheads. So here is the SwiftColor STL4000D printer, and I'm just going to quickly remove the ink cartridges and pack them up. Open this front door here. You have access to your ink cartridges. You flip down the blue lever and you pull out the cartridge. And you can see I've got a pretty full black cartridge here. You see they're nice big 240 milliliter cartridges. So they have a lot of ink in them. And you can replace them all independently. So next time when they start it up, you put the ink cartridges in, you flip those on, close the door, and it is ready to go.
Another part of shipping process, what I like to do is remove the maintenance cartridge, and that is located on the side of the printer here, the bottom of the drawer, and you just pull it out. There's the maintenance cartridge, and we're just going to pack that up. Now when you go to start the printer back up, you want to put this part in first. It just slides in, close the door, and then you want to go around the front of the printer and install your ink cartridges. Once again, you're going to push down and slide that open, put the cartridge in, and clip it back up. Then you can start the printer, and it will go through the cleaning process, and you should be ready to go.